Kunnen hier wel goed zien dat de edition of beta that's peer review is me. Dave the beta back again to do another peer review. This is one of Blue Dog's overworks. I've kind of picked up most of them. There's a few that I haven't got. this is the overworks Funk times Punk. This is a flagship IPA. It gets funked and punked. For an immense lesson in fermentation, aging giant foeders and dry hop to oblivion, new world meets new in this retained ale. Perfectly balanced funk and complex flavours, tropical fruits on the nose followed by punchy juicy dry notes, and little spice packed up to the rafters with citrus hop flavours. A silky, chewy body culminates in a canvas dry finish. Funk by Punk, united in beers. Product of Scotland, aged in foeders. 5.5% ABV, says so there. Best before is 7th of December 21, says so there. And as you can see, the price, it cost me £6 for this 5ml bottle. There's the lid. The Overworks lid. I suppose the best thing to drink this out of would be an Overworks glass, but I don't have one in at home. I have one elsewhere. So if I get around to it, I'll do an Overworks one over the weekend. So, Funk by Pug. Let's see what we've got. Let's see what this is all about. A little bit of smoke off the top when I popped it. Again, don't know why I didn't pop it in front of you. Wasn't thinking. So let's pour, let's see what we get. I read a bit about this beer. There's supposed to be a little bit of a sourness to it. We shall soon see. And again, for those of you who regularly watch Beer Dad's Beer Reviews, you'll know I quite like sours. So, what have we got beer in the glass there? We are looking at hazy, cloudy, burnt orange, dirty orange beer. We've got very soapy head, about a finger and a half, very rocky head, as you can see, it's dissipating quite rapidly, which indicates to me that it could very well be soured. There is no particulates in this beer whatsoever that I can see anyway, no big chunks of anything. Doesn't mean there isn't, it could just all be the bottom of this. So, looks okay. Let's just get in and see what we can smell. There is something there. It says a funk. There is a funkiness to it. I don't know whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, to be fair. Aroma, you get a sort of citrus and mangoes and really ripe fruit. Not much else, really. Bit of grape. Okay, let's give it a taste. Cheers. First thing, it's not that tart. I was surprised, I thought it was going to be quite sour, but it's not. The carbonation is quite light, the body's really light, and it's nearly watery. Flavour wise, there's not much to it, if I'm being perfectly honest with you. There's a little bit of sweetness. Fruity sweetness, a little bit of citrus peel coming through, a bit of zest, but not sort of fruity. No sort of pine traces, which I didn't think there would be. There's a bit of a bready feel going on. The funk, it's a yeastiness that travels through from the aroma into the beer. There's a yeastiness there. So this funk they're talking about. I say there's a bit of a grapiness, bit of grapiness to it. The Brett sort of does say on the front it's Brett fermented IPA. Yeah, well, I'm not a lover of Brett beers, to be fair. There's a little bit of pepper as well. A little bit of pepper going on. I don't know if I like this or not. Probably not. It's not, I wouldn't say it was a grower. He said sloshed under the floor. I wouldn't say it was a grower. The body, I say, the body's light, almost watery, but it's also a little bit velvety, a bit cloy, a bit claggy. It feels like it's leaving a chalky film across the back of my throat, across the roof of my mouth. It isn't, but that's what I'm getting that feeling. So maybe it is. It's not fantastic. I don't know what everyone's. People I've spoken to have raved about this, it's great, but I don't think this is any kind of decent beer at all, considering what they do. Yeah, it's a little chalky, a little minerally. Lacklustre in flavour. Smells good, tastes crap. Yeah, there's not a lot to this. Not a lot at all. I'd be avoiding this if I was out buying beer. Excuse me. Yeah, it's just crap. Doesn't taste too much. Smells good. Doesn't taste too much. All the flavours all subdued. It's not great. But it's making me sneeze. Excuse me, I do apologise. Something I've never done before. Excuse me. On 667 videos, I've never sneezed like that before. It's yeasty. It's flavourless, really. I'm not a lover. So. Goodness me, someone's got up my nose. Funk by Punk. Or Funk times Punk. Do I like it? No. Would I buy it again? No. Would I recommend it to friends? No. It's not good. Fucking hell. There's something in this beer that doesn't agree with me. I don't know what it is. I don't like it. I think it tastes rubbish. There's very flavour to it. So there you go. So if you've had this beer, let me know what you think. Put a comment below. There'll be a link to the BrewDog website as usual. Subscribe there or there. God, there's something in there that does not agree with me. So subscribe to there or there. Do that if you like the video. Do that if you don't. I'll see you in the next one. This is going in the bin. I'm actually into the recycle. Never to be seen again. Hail the ale.